Well, friends, good morning on a Thursday morning here at Downsview Baptist Church. Sorry for the Facebook Live having to be postponed last night. We had a tragic passing of a dear friend of Pam and I back from our time in Thunder Bay, and appreciate many of you taking the time to pray for us and for the family. Not being too public about the details of who exactly it is at this point, there's some family details that are still taking place. None of you would know these people, but I'm grateful that you have upheld us and them in your prayers, and would encourage you to do that in the coming days. You know, one of the things about this whole COVID time that has been impacting all of us is how friendly our friends are, and how those who are dear and close friends have shown themselves to be that. And those who have done so have been, I think, in a special way appreciated by many of us, haven't they? We're grateful for people who are willing to say follow the safety protocols, but at the same time who are not so averse to risk that they don't spend some time with us, safely distanced and that kind of thing. At the same time, those who are willing to take the extra effort for these crazy technology things, to go on a computer and try Zoom and maybe a Facebook Live, or I think it's FaceTime on the Apple products and the iPhones, that kind of thing. And even to send a special letter perhaps in the mail, or a card, those who have taken the time to send meals around by sending a takeout to somebody's place. Amazon has become our great friend, hasn't it, in terms of delivery and doing that safely, and people who've been sending parcels to each other. People are sending words of encouragement through email, and simply picking up a telephone and connecting with people. And you know, there's always a sense that when we think about these things, we always think, or I often think anyway, you know, I can see my shortcomings and where I've fallen down and wished I did better and more complete. And you go to bed at the end of the night and you're being grateful for God's kindness throughout the day, and then you think, you know, I wanted to talk to so-and-so, I haven't contacted this person yet, it's been so long since then. And then someone tells you, you know, they're really looking forward to hearing from you, or, you know, they haven't heard from you. And we, in some ways, that can be helpful to do that. But, you know, it can feel discouraging when you think, oh, one more thing that I wish I had done better. You know, this morning, I find myself particularly grateful, not just for my long-term friendship with my buddy who lost his wife, for the years and years and 40 plus years that we've been friends. But this morning we had a Zoom call with our Feb Central Toronto Association pastors. David Robinson, who is the pastor at Westminster Chapel here in Toronto, chairs our association meeting. And there's, you know, anywhere from 6 to 12 folks who come on every Thursday morning at 10 o'clock to just share a prayer request, pray for each other, and get on with our day. And David's been helpful with the discipline of us not just chatting. There's times for that, and it's a good time to do it. And sometimes I ask guys either to stay on, or I'll give them a phone call afterwards, we'll follow up on something. But that priority of bringing each other before the Lord. You know, brothers and sisters in the Lord are precious and valuable. And especially those of us in pastoral ministry. I remember Al Mohler a number of years ago. Al Mohler is the president of Southern Baptist Seminary, widely read and listened to Christian leader in the U.S. And he mentioned at one of the conferences that they were having amongst his friends and said, you know, I just don't think we're going to make it on our own. And when it comes to brothers in the Lord in particular who love each other and are co-laboring together, I've just felt that keenly these past 12, 13 months, whatever it's been now that we started this COVID. But it's because I knew that going into it. You know, most of you know that Fort William Baptist Church in Thunder Bay is our home church, where I spent a decade being trained and ministering there. And we had a group in Thunder Bay called the Bee Gees, and we always kid about our theme song with Staying Alive, but Bee Gees just stand for the Baptist guys. And we had at one point 10 churches that were from four different denominations. One was even independent, so four different groups at least, categories. And we would get together every month, and we'd have lunch together, and we'd share our lives together, we'd pray for each other. We had two major services throughout the year. We had a Good Friday service where we had 800-900 people at one point that would all get together, and we'd have to rent one of the other churches, and we'd all come together, and each of us would have a role as different brothers in it. And we would have evening services in the summer when someone would preach at another guy's church, and then we would alternate that way. And this obvious love and partnership. When I moved to Sault Ste. Marie, there wasn't as many guys, and in some ways it was a bit of a new thing to really connect that way beyond sort of a superficial ministerial level, but really with a core of shared beliefs and love for each other. And that grew over the 6 years that Pam and I spent in Sault Ste. Marie. And so I come from a place in the Algoma Association of FEB, which had six churches in the region, to Toronto, where we have, it's the other side of 50 churches in our association here, the largest association in not just the province, but in Canada. And to get guys together like this is just wonderful. And I commend David Robinson's leadership. I thank God for him. I thank God for his perseverance and his focus. And you know, it strikes me that at the end of the book of Romans, chapter 16, the Apostle Paul gives this list of people that he's thankful for. And I know there's a risk. Some of us are so averse to that risk that we never want to give thanks for anyone publicly, especially in a worship service, because, right, we might forget someone. So to be sure that we don't forget someone and someone's not offended by being forgotten or left to another time, who knows what the motivation is. Just because someone isn't mentioned doesn't mean we've forgotten them, but it might mean that. So the advice of some camps is, well, don't ever say anything. Never point out a birthday. Never point out an anniversary. Never make the point that someone's, had a particular achievement in their college life or in their preschool life, or that someone's done something with their parents, or, something's happening in the life of someone because we might forget someone. It's just not the way any of us really want to live, is it? And it says something about how thin-skinned sometimes we are on behalf of other people. You know, they're going to be offended if you say something about this person and not that person. And you know me, after, we're pushing 4 years this summer, I'm willing to take that risk. And if we forget and we miss someone, okay, let's do it the next time. And oftentimes it's quite strategic, frankly, on my part. And we saw that, didn't we, in these last about 3 months or so, as Pavlo and Tatiana encouraged us, said, why don't we put the pictures of people from our church up on the screen and we can actually pray for them by name specifically. And we saw it was worth the risk, right? Nobody said, oh, you know what, if you don't do everybody every Sunday, it's not going to be worth it. Nobody thought that. And you know, the Apostle Paul shows us that and models something of that, doesn't he, at the end of the book of Romans. And I think we need to take it seriously, because again, we need each other. And those of you who know the people who care for you and have a shared commitment to the Lord Jesus Christ and speak the same language, if you will, and understand what we mean by certain terms and categories, and we've been through some of the same situations, and we held the same values, and we have the same vision and a picture of going forward, there's something about the comfort of that familiarity. There's attendant dangers there as well, I know that, but there's something about appreciating what God gives us that way. Romans chapter 16, he says in verse 1, I commend to you our servant Phoebe, our sister Phoebe, a servant, servants of the church in Cenchrea, that you may welcome her in the Lord in a way worthy of the saints, and help her in whatever she may need from you, for she has been a patron of many and of myself as well. Greet Priscilla and Aquila, my fellow workers in Christ Jesus, who risked their necks for my life, to whom not only I give thanks, but all the churches of the Gentiles give thanks as well. Greet also the church in their house. Greet my beloved Epaphras, who was the first convert to Christ in Asia. Greet Mary, who has worked hard for you. Greet Antrochitus and Junia, my kinsmen from my fellow prisoners. They're well known to the apostles, and they were in Christ before me. Amphileus, my beloved in the Lord, Urbanus, our fellow worker in Christ, my beloved Stachys, and I know I'm butchering some of these names, friends, but you just go down from verse 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Greet Phygelus, Julia, Nerus, and his sister Olympus, and all the saints who are with them. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the churches of Christ greet you. It's just again and again and again, and just with this kind of specificity and risk of missing someone. I don't think that's every single person that Paul has ever been thankful for. But he thanks them and gives divine commendation to them and praises God because of them and invites people into it. Come worship, right? Come enjoy the Lord together with me. Let us exalt his name together, as the book of Proverbs says. And he invites us to do that together. Be a great exercise for us as a church family over the next few days and maybe even culminating on Sunday morning. Who are you grateful for amongst the church family at Downsview Baptist Church? That if we were writing a letter back to one of our churches that we had some connection with, and we want to commend people within the church who've been an encouragement, who've been helpful, who've been encouraging and helpful because of their steadfastness, because of their consistency, because just of simply their presence. They're not talking about some massive achievement. They did this, they did this, they did this. Go with me and just look around at the church. Just think about this environment that's here at the church that's often full of our friends. And just go in your mind's eye and think, you know, there's something about, and give thanks for that. And ask God to bring them to our remembrance. To ask God to make us thankful. I know we are frustrating to each other and we've got all kinds of warts and difficulties and challenges. Some of you may have read on the Facebook yesterday, I had a quote on there from John Newton, the tender-hearted pastor, theologian, and of course, hymn writer of Amazing Grace. And John Newton had a quote there, and it's in the spirit of another quote that he said, was that someone whose heart has been truly gripped by Christ will love his fellow believers. He loves them at first sight. And there's just something about that there's a recognition that any defect, default, disappointment that we see in another believer, we realize the only thing that makes us different from them is the grace of God. And again, you hear the Apostle Paul saying, listen, who has made you to differ from another? And the answer rhetorically, of course, is the Lord. And so let's ask God, friends, as we need one another, we're designed to need one another, we've been provided with one another, particularly here in our church family, and we haven't seen well over half of our church for a year, most of us. And as these things continue to develop forward, let's just ask God that he would guard us from disinterest or forgetfulness. And he would replace that with a real sense of deep appreciation for those who are part of the family of God here at Downsview Baptist Church. Let's pray that in, shall we, friends? All right, cheers.